We've all done that for last 5 years. Scratch to everything in 5 years or developed last 5 years. It's already written. Your initiative on it is should. বলছি মানে আমার মতে কি করতে হবে মুকেশ, শুড বি স্টার্ট নাও?
Yes, sir.
Okay, friends, good afternoon. We are the meeting here for to hear the talk number 3 of Azadi Ka Amrut Mahotsav. As you know, we are in the 75th year of our independence. And today, Dr. Mukesh Ranjan, one of my colleagues with whom I have worked for many years, he is going to give the talk. He is an M.Tech from IIT Kanpur. After that, he joined IPR as a scientific C in FCIPD. And we have worked on the many projects, mostly sponsored from the Department of Space as well as Department of Science and Technology, as well as in-house projects. And then he subsequently went to Germany, got his PhD from Technical University of Dresden. Though his entire research was conducted in the research center, the Rosendorf or Forschungszentrum Rosendorf as it's called. And he did his PhD in 2011, he was awarded the degree and he worked on nano patterning of surfaces. After coming back in IPR, he established a lab at FCIPT specializing in the nanopatterning of surfaces, various surfaces, and then they developed the various applications. He has also guided many students. Some of them are very well placed, both within India as well as abroad. And he also has a credit of many papers in extremely good journals, like the Nature Scientific Reports, Journal of Applied Physics Letters, as well as other journals related with thin films and the coatings. So with this background, I would like to invite Dr. Mukesh Ranjan to give his talk. He will be giving a popular talk, and at the end of his talk, you may ask the questions. So Dr. Mukesh Ranjan, please start.
Thank you, sir. Am I audible clearly?
Yes.
Is my presentation is also visible?
Presentation is not visible at the moment.
Is it visible now?
Yes, please go ahead.
Yeah, once again, thank you very much. Actually, Dr. Mukherjee is my mentor. Whatever I have learned in my life, starting from my career, so he actually shaped my career and guided me to become an experimental plasma physicist. And so that today's the motive of this talk is I was just reading about what is the vision behind the Azadi Ka Amrut Mahotsav. So whatever we have done in our field after the independence, we should celebrate that, and we have to see that how we progress further. So before I start, I would like to thank all of my colleagues of FCIPT who are actually not now today, they are not part of FCIPT, but they were earlier part of FCIPT. They have contributed to many, many plasma-based technologies. And so whatever I'm going to show today is actually I have taken data from my current colleagues who are working in different application-oriented plasma-based technologies. So I would like to, before I start, I would like to acknowledge the work, tremendous work done by the entire FCIPT team over a period of years. and then see how we proceed further. And we highly believe in Make in India concept. So we try to make developed systems which are indigenously in our division. So that we make in India concept we strictly follow. So because this talk is basically is also dedicated for the very basic concept for the students. So just to brief you what is plasma before I started talking about the applications. So the general understanding about plasma is that we know that solid, liquid and gas everywhere whatever we see is made of some atoms. So we have atoms which are tightly bounded together by atomic bonds. So we call it as a solid. The typical example shown in this picture is, for example, ice. If you give some energy to this atom, they feel a little bit free to move, and then they can allow to change their dimension. So we call it as a liquid state of the matter. If you further give some energy, so they become free, like we are breathing the oxygen gas, or it is everywhere present, all the atmospheric gases. So they are freely moving inside our atmosphere. So that is a gaseous state. They are no longer bounded together. But as we know, our basic understanding that the bottom image you can see. Let me see. Yeah. So electron is actually revolving around a nucleus. So in the center we have a positive charge, and in the surrounding we have electron cloud, which is electrons are moving in the surrounding. So if you give additional energy to this electron, which are actually essentially bounded together because ions are positive, the nucleus is positive and electron is negative. So ideally they do not want to leave each other, but if you somehow give them some energy, so this state is known as the ionization state of the matter. And if you are able to maintain it, for example, you keep on giving energy continuously by, it can be electrical energy, it can be laser energy, it can be some other kind of energy. You keep on giving the energy to the atoms and maintain this situation. So what we'll have, you will have ions, you will have electrons, and you will have neutrals. So this combination of electron, ions, and neutrals is actually popularly known as the plasma state of the matter. And so because of this ionization state, you have positive charge, you have negative charge. This gives you freedom for controlling them very nicely using different parameters. And that can be changed from application you are looking for. So the fourth example you see, typically example what you see in the rainy season, the lightning, is an example of plasma state only. Why my slide is not moving? Yeah, these are some real life example which you normally see in your day-to-day life. So I told that lightning is one of these state of plasma. So what happened in the clouds, we are very and entire the whole year the charge is actually accumulated. We have what we have in the sky is the droplets, water droplets, and the electrons are which are coming from the from various sources. So there's a charge accumulation happening, and basically it is floating charge which is moving from one place to another place. And once it is beyond a certain limit, or the atmosphere is very humid, they found it ground, and then they try to short circuit it. So and that's how they make a plasma, very intense plasma. The cigarette, what you smoke, is a kind of plasma only, is a very weak ionizing plasma. The sun, which is continuously giving us energy since many years, it's also a form of a plasma. This is a very the globe which normally we gift it to the people is also kind of plasma only. You will see it in many gift shop, and the tube light what you see in our houses, it also have a kind of plasma only, which actually have a plasma inside which emits the electron, and then you have a fluorescence tubes which actually emits the light. So these are some examples which you see in your day-to-day life. What happened to the mouse? So one can actually do a very simple lab experiment. This is again a special example for students. So if you take two plates, parallel plates, and you give very high potential, this is a DC power supply which is connected to these electrodes. So what you see, and you put a candle in between these two. So what is candle is actually is a very weakly ionized form of a plasma. So when you are burning the candle, the plume of the candle is actually ionizing the gases which are available in the surrounding. So if you give a positive potential to one plate and negative potential to the another plate, you will actually see that the candle is actually moving in one direction. The reason for the same is shown in this bottom schematic, that positive charge will like to go toward the negative potential, and negative ions, electrons will like to go toward the positive plate. So in this way, there's a slight change in the orientation of the plume of the candle. And if you go very close to this candle, you can actually see arcing like behavior, like you see in the lightning season, in the rainy season. So if you are very close, so literally there is a possibility of current can flow from one electrode to another electrode because of the flow of the charge. Another very common example is the racket you are using in your house. When you are killing a mosquito, at that time there is a short circuit between the two electrodes. So you can actually see a very intense current generated there, and you see a bright spot that is also kind of plasma only. And the welding process, what you see in your day-to-day life, that is also a kind of plasma process only. So typically, as I told, that plasma is a fourth state of matter where you have electrons, ions, and neutral gas molecules available. And we can control them by giving additional electric field, by giving additional magnetic field. So popularly, we can actually divide the plasma in two categories. One is the cold plasma. The cold plasma means the electron temperature is very, very high than the gas molecule temperature. And it is not harming any object which is coming in contact with this cold plasma. They are not making any damage to this. In this picture, what you see, some components, they are actually immersed inside the plasma. So the shape and the appearance and everything remain more or less the same. So they are not giving any heat to the substrate. So normally this kind of cold plasma is used for surface modification processes. Another example is the hot plasma, where the electron temperature is equally and the gas temperature, they are more or less the same. So the heat capacity in this case is very high. The plasma density is also very high. The temperature of the gas molecule is also very high, so that they can transport the heat from plasma to the body. So this kind of process can be used normally used for the waste disposal, for disposing the waste, and for some metallurgical application where you can literally melt the material, like the case of welding. In the welding, we are making the joints of two materials. So you are actually melting one material and then making a joint. So in this animation, what you can see is a very crude example of a plasma. So what happened when the plasma ions and electrons, they are something is. Yeah. So in this animation, what I want to show you, that electrons, once they are coming out from the atoms, they are much, much mobile than compared to the ions. So ions are very slow as compared to electrons. So the moment the electrons are coming out, the ions very slowly, they move toward the surface following the electrons. So in this way, whenever you bring anything in contact with the ions, anything in contact with the plasma, what will happen? Electrons will immediately reach to that surface, and following them, the ions will also reach to the surface. They make a plasma sheet in front of the substrate which is coming in contact with the plasma. And that's how you can actually, if you give some additional potential to the substrate, you can actually make modification on the surface. You can actually clean your surface. So plasma will like to remain neutral, whatever you immerse inside the plasma. But plasma ion, they can actually be tuned to give some additional energy to make surface modifications. So this concept is more or less used in many of the applications what I'm going to show you today. So based on this brief introduction about the plasma, there are many applications of plasma. As you see, it is used even in our real life. We are using already many things which are actually in the behind. If you see, there some plasma technologies there, like in the automobile sector. I will be showing you that the components which are used in there are already having some coating which was performed using the plasma processing method, like carbon. Diamond-like carbon coatings, which makes the component very hard, or some plasma nitriding process, which makes the tool very stronger. So some in the automobile industries, people are using plasma technologies. Tokamak is the one example where Institute of Plasma Research, our institute, is actually working, having in mind a futuristic project where actually the energy will be generated using the fusion concept. Waste disposal, agriculture, like the example I will show you, that how you can actually increase the shelf life of the material using some plasma technologies. For medical films, so plasma medicine is actually coming in a very big way. Many application of plasma related technologies are coming. Plasma application for textile, you can actually modify the textile surfaces and then make them more useful. plasma nanotechnology also is now different branch where people are actually making different ICs, different magnetic memories using the plasma processes. And then plasma also has a lot of application in space. The example shown here is the plasma thruster, which are used for changing the orientation of the satellite. So I will touch some of them today one by one. So before that, so my institute facilitation center for industrial plasma technology was actually initiated in 1997 with the intention that the whatever technologies, plasma-based technologies are actually developed in the institute, they can be transferred to the industries. Slowly, slowly, many branches started working in this division. Some of them, they are actually listed here, like plasma for space application, plasma for pilotages, I already told. So I will touch these one by one. So what is the waste is a huge problem nowadays in any city. And if you see, you will see the plastic everywhere lying on the either on the road or wherever you go to some sea coast or in some any place where you go, many, if it is a crowded place, you will see some kind of plastic waste is there. And another type of waste is the medical waste. In any hospital where the surgical operation are going on, you will see that not only the plastic waste is there, but also the body parts which are actually taken out from the body. They simply, what they do, they actually dump it in the end of the some city, and then slowly, slowly, this waste is getting piled up. So that's why in any big city now, it's a big threat. And especially for hospital, what happened, if the person has some hazardous disease and you shift its body from one place to another place, and it happened that the dog which is moving in that area eat that stuff, and then it again goes to the surrounding slum area. So the disease can transfer from one place to the another place. So this is a very big problem. Another very big problem is now, because everybody's has realized now we are wearing the mask. So after using the mask, people very casually, they throw it at any place. So in future, it will be a very, very big waste how to dispose of the used mask. And the another already well-known problem is the electronic. So electronic is growing very fast, but simultaneously, when the new technology is coming, the old technology is vanishes, it leaves behind a lot of waste. So how to dispose of this waste? So our institute has developed a technology which is known as the plasma pyrolysis system. In this plasma pyrolysis system, typically we use a very energetic plasma torches. And in the presence of these plasma torches, we actually decompose our plastic or medical waste. So that typically temperature is very high, around 5,000 to 10,000 Kelvin. So and it's a very clean technology which is successfully developed after performing over a period of several experiments. And so what it basically doing, it is defragmenting the polymer chains of the plastic so that it breaks to it breaks to up to that extent that finally it is releasing the environment friendly gases in the atmosphere. So no dioxin and furans available in the gases which are coming out from this pyrolysis system. And there's a volumetric reduction of the waste. So normally what happens, people either they burn their waste. So when you burn something, you not only release the hazardous gases, but also you finally what remain is the ash or some kind of waste product which is remain in, after the decomposition. But in this process, it is 99% volumetric reduction is there in the of the waste material. So because of this and regarding the, because it is also releasing the UV radiation, so plasma is known as a very good sterilization. So it is killing many kind of bacteria. So it's a safe method. So if it, some waste is coming from the hospitals, it will also kill the dangerous bacteria also. So this, because of this, so many advantages of this plasma pyrolysis system, it is found superior to be many other technologies, competitive technologies. And it was approved by Center Pollution Control Board of India. And already we institute has transferred this technology to some companies and also already installed some system at different places of India. So this is a typical results, how the covered carbon monoxide and NOx and a particular matter, they were found to be much, much lower than the recommended values, what is coming out from the pyrolysis system. And this kind of test were performed with the help of Center Pollution Control Board in their presence, and was successfully approved. So the system what you see on the left side, it is a 15 kg per hour plasma pyrolysis system, which was installed in Goa Medical College. And on the right side, you see a histogram which shows that how the monthly the amount of waste were actually removed using this small capacity system. So totally 3.5 tons of waste disposal was performed in 1 year duration. So already our institute is now working on many other applications of this plasma pyrolysis system to how to increase the capacity using the advanced plasma torches, advanced power supplies, advanced designs, and fully automatic system. Another such example is of this kind of plasma pyrolysis system is which is installed in the GIFT City. So GIFT City is a smart city where every floor is actually connected to this plasma pyrolysis system, so that the paper waste can be actually directly reached to the system, and nobody so no personnel needed. So you there's an opening in every floor, so simply dump your garbage there, and then there are very high speed suction pumps which can actually suck out the material from every floor, and then it can directly go to this plasma pyrolysis system. So many such demands are coming time to time for this plasma pyrolysis system. People are coming with different kind of ideas, and different kind of waste can be proposed to be treated using this plasma pyrolysis system. With this, now I will move to the another technology which is actually used for increasing the lifetime of steel components. You know that originally, most of the industries they are using any kind of tools. So mainly the steel is ruling the industries. So all the components, either bearing or automobile component or tools, they are made of some kind of steel. So we have developed a plasma nitriding process in which actually the tools is actually immersed inside the plasma, and then we generate a nitrogen and hydrogen plasma inside. And by giving a potential to the steel component, we can actually attract the nitrogen ions towards these tools, and then they can go deep inside submicron levels and make it more hard, as well as the corrosive resistance. So over a period of time, we have developed a database of different kind of steels component, and time to time we are also doing the job shop work for different industries. So I would like to show you how this plasma nitriding process actually happened in a real time scale. So in this movie, I hope you will be able to see. So first you clean the sample, if it is a very small sample, otherwise plasma nitriding process can be used for any big component also. So these are some tools which are loaded in before the plasma nitriding process. And after that, I can run it. This is an example of just small tools. So you can see that we can actually mount a number of such tools in one shot. And depending on the how much cage depth or how much hardness we need to run the process accordingly. So the process can run for 12 hours, the process can run for 24 hours. So depending on the requirement or kind of steel we are using, the plasma nitriding process has to be used. So now you will see that how the, in a couple of, yeah, so you can see in this slide that now the slowly the plasma started forming, and suddenly you will see that it is fully the beauty for this project is that it is independent of the shape. So plasma actually surrounded depending on the kind of shape you want to do plasma nitriding, the plasma will actually surround that irrespective of the shape, and then it performs the plasma nitriding process. So this technology also has been successfully transferred to companies, and regularly we are doing job shop work for different industries. Some of the component of which are actually used in satellites, they are also being treated with the plasma nitriding, because what happened during the launching period, the satellite remain at the sea course for a longer period, so there is a chances for that the steel component may get rusted. So we have already supplied the plasma nitriding system to ISRO units, as well as they are also sending their components time to time. Another example you can see of some big component which are kept in this such a bigger system, and they are getting plasma nitrated. Okay. So these are some typical examples which can be actually treated using the plasma nitrating process. Another example, a very good example of plasma is what we have done is to treat the valve which are used in again in the automobile industries. So Titron valve, which is a very one of the biggest company which is actually developing this kind of valve, which are using either in our scooters, truck tires, or other. So what they were actually doing, they are doing this rubber to brass bond using some chemical process. So in this process, they actually, after doing the chemical process, they were throwing this, or you have to dispose this chemical which are used. So it was a it was not good for the society if you decompose it either in on some sea or on some, or simply dip it into some places. So what we have observed that if you treat this brass valve with the plasma, so that the addition of this polymer to this brass valve drastically improved. And for this, after doing several testing, that this technology was developed. And what you see again, that we have actually developed a very big system where many of the valve can be treated simultaneously. So what you see, this the brass valve actually kept, and every brass valve is actually a live electrode of the plasma, so that the ion will hit it and then they will clean the surface. The process is very easy to understand. So normally, for example, when you clean a surface, for let us say using a sandpaper, so sandpaper has the sand particle or the glass particle which are separated by each other by few micron or by millimeter. So when you are rubbing it on a surface, what you are actually you are removing the impurities available on the surface, as well as you are making the free bonds available on the surface, so that it can react fast easily to the chemical you want to paste on it. So in the plasma process, it is not the glass atom, it is the atom is actually hitting the another atom. So in this case, you can imagine the difference. It is atom to atom interaction as compared to the normal manual cleaning. So when you are, one atom is actually cleaning, interacting with another atom, you are literally doing an atomic level cleaning in the plasma process. So that's why it's very efficient, it's very homogeneous, and so plasma-based cleaning of surface is a very well-known process nowadays for doing any kind of coating. First, people are treat their substrate with plasma. If you want to do any chemical addition on the surface, it's better to treat it using plasma technologies. So this was a very successful technology for developing, for etching the brass surface for the nodule walls. With this, I would like to now show you some example how the plasma technology can be used for health sector. So what we have developed is a very handy pencil plasma torch, which can be work at atmosphere. So you can see that in these pictures. And this is a pencil plasma torch is now has been tested for different application, the cancer treatment, skin treatment, blood coagulation, tooth cleaning, sterilization, and the pesticide removal. So not only we have developed the single plume pencil plasma torch, but also the multiple plume plasma torches. So again, in this movie, what you will see that this pencil plasma torch, which is developed in our institute, my colleague Akshayvedh is actually touching it on his hand. You can see, so it's not giving any shock to the body. So which essentially tells that it can be. I mean, one can simply feel that something is touching to your body, but it's not any harmful. So that's why it's the ease of use of this pencil plasma torch has given the application. And it's not the power supply which I use is not very big, it's very handy power supply. This is another example of touching the pencil plasma torch on the hands. So the same pencil plasma torch has been used for a fungal treatment. So what you see here in this movie, I will talk more about in a slide about this. And in this, what you see, we are trying to treat with the help of Cancer Research Institute, Mumbai, artificially generated oral cancer cell, and how the pencil plasma torch is actually treating it. So this project is also going on in a collaborative mode. But before we develop any product for the human being, we have to do some animal trials. So this is a part of that animal trial, that how whether pencil plasma torch can be used for oral cancer cell treatment for so this example you also see in the case of hamster. So we have done for many hamster experiment in collaboration. So first you have to artificially make the cancer and then see its effect. So what you see, for example, the example of hamster case. So day one, first treatment, and day by day, so we give some dose which are actually decided by the Cancer Research Institute. Slowly, what you see that after the treatment, the 10th day and the 11th day, whatever actually cancer was developed on the mouth, it get blackish in color, and then suddenly it was not growing further, and it actually removed from the it almost removed from the buccal. So many a time it happened that every hamster has a different immunity. So because cancer is a fight between the human body and the cancerous cell, so sometimes it happened that when you artificially introduce the want to generate the cancer, it's not developing, so your experiment will get failed. Sometimes the plasma, when you are interacting, it is also not responding because the cancer is much more stronger than what treatment you are doing. In the radiation therapy, already the process is very well defined. You know how much dose you have to give, depending on the size or depending on the, because it's the experience which has been generated over several years of time. But in case of plasma, even though we have seen successfully that it, yes, it is helping to kill actually the oral cancer cell, but the dose and the further optimization of the experiment are actually going on, and it's every time it's a big process when you have to generate the cancer and then you have to perform the experiment. After that, lot of experiments and the analysis is performed just to see whether the cancer cells are actually decaying. So this work is very positively going on in collaboration. Another example which I told you, that the skin treatment. So we have done some experiment with the help of PG Medical College. One of our collaborator actually taken these pencil plasma torch. And this tea necrosis is a very common disease among the laborers in the West Bengal region. It looks like eczema on the body, and it generates some kind of itching also on the surface. So traditionally, doctors are giving a cream which is used, and then after a certain period, this again come out on the same place in a bigger manner. And the affordability of this cream is also not easy for the laborers. So we have tested successfully that the pencil plasma dot treatment was successfully able to treat this this tea necrosis fungal infection. After several trials, it was found on different patient. So it was also a very successful attempt to use this pencil plasma torch for removing the skin treatment. Another example is cleaning the surfaces, the tooth. So normally doctors, they use some kind of chemicals. They tell you that you gargle it, maybe it can shine your teeth. But the easy way is you can simply take this pencil plasma torch, and then after a few treatment, it can slowly remove the yellowish sulfur or which is deposited on your teeth can be removed. So it's a plasma because it's a surface treatment process, so definitely increase the cleanness of your teeth. Another very useful example of this pencil plasma torch is the blood coagulation. So naturally our blood takes some time, depending on the again person to person, it takes some time blood to coagulate. So what we have observed, that if you treat this pencil plasma torch to any wound or to the blood, the coagulation time actually significantly reduced. So that's how you can actually nowadays see on some YouTube clips, doctors are using after finishing their operation, they are using this kind of pencil plasma torches so that the blood should coagulate as soon as possible, and there should not be any blood loss in the body. So this is also very one of the good application, and we have also personally tested it with the help of some pathology, that blood coagulation is very fast with the help of pencil plasma torches. Another example of is the removal of pesticide which are normally used on this vegetables or on the fruits, is also very dangerous for the human body. So if you take it, it is poisonous. So there is a possibility that if you treat your vegetable or fruit with pencil plasma torch, so you can see that the pesticide, the amount of number of molecules of pesticide which are available on the surface, they actually erase very fast. So based on the multi-jet pencil plasma torch, actually you can treat the large area, and that's how you can actually remove step by step the pesticide from the surfaces. The example I'm just showing you, the test which we have performed at our place. So you just have to expose it, even such a small exposure of the pencil, the plasma to the vegetable is sufficient to remove the pesticide molecule significantly. And remember, pesticide molecule, they actually choose a site. Normally what we do at our home, we already wash our vegetables. So even after washing, there are certain places like in capsicum, just on the top, lot of molecules they trap inside. So that's how, so even the water cleaning is not, in certain cases it is working. So maybe in future you expect a microwave like system where the plasma shower type of torches will be mounted. You just keep it for some certain time and then it will remove the pesticides from your surface. Another application of plasma in the health science is the plasma sterilization. Plasma sterilization is very well now stabilized in the medical fraternity. So traditionally, if any surgical tool or any equipment, they were actually water heated. So you dip it in the water and then hot it, boil it in the steam. So, but still there are some certain bacteria which are actually not killed at a very, very high temperature. So plasma has been found and different kind of plasma has been found to kill the whatever bacteria have listed here, like E. coli bacteria, Salmonella, Ebonyi, and different other people we have tried in our institute with the help of some institute, and successfully developed this plasma sterilization technology. And as I know that worldwide, there are companies who are selling the plasma-based sterilizer. So similarly, so we have also developed this plasma sterilizer. It has many applications. So what is written here that indigenously developed plasma sterilization system is helping as a substitute for conventional technologies like autoclave, chemical-based sterilizer, and reduce the cost of import by 3 to 4 times. So if we, what system we have developed, the cost of this system is because it's indigenously made and literally manual system operation. So the cost is very less in this case. With this, I would like to show you some application of for related with agriculture. Plasma helps for the seed germination. So what you see in this picture are the some seeds which are treated by oxygen plasma. So the problem is with the germination is in the any seed has some hard coating on top of it. So this hard coating actually prevent it from different kind of atmospheric pathogen or bacteria, but it also create problem for the fast germination. So if somehow we remove this the shell of this of the seed, it the germination rate increases. So another very important thing is normally what we do, we give urea or other chemicals to our our soil so that it give fertilize very fast. So in the plasma treatment, because we are modifying the surface, we are actually activating the surface and we are making some kind of nanostructure on the surface, which typically help to absorb the constituent of either the nitrogen or the oxygen or the minerals to the seed's body, and then actually it improves the germination rate of the material. So again, the agriculture universities, we are doing collaborative work for different kind of seeds, and so we have developed this system and successfully tested. But the problem is with the seed, any kind of agriculture application, it's very time consuming. So every time you take a you treat it with the plasma and then you have to wait for your result for a longer time, and then it's a statistical process. Thousands of sheets you repeat and then you see how many of them actually getting good result, how many of them are not actually responding. So slowly this kind of work is also going on in collaboration. So this is what I was telling. So this is an example of capsicum seed. So the contact angle of the capsicum seed is 89 degree before treatment, and once you actually treat it with the plasma, you already see on the right, on the left side, some kind of roughness is generated on the plasma treated surface, which actually helps not only to remove the shell of the sheet, but also it helps to absorb different minerals, different oxygen and nitrogen species on the surface, which helps to grow the sheet further. Another very recent and very novel application nowadays is coming up, is the plasma activated water. So if you treat the water with plasma, it generates a lot of species inside the water, typically the nitrogen oxygen combinations and the pure oxygen combination. So different species of or the radical actually produce inside the plasma, and this is a kind of amrit, I will say. So when you treat your plasma activated water, you use for you clean any vegetable. The example you see is the example of tomatoes. So normally you see after 2 or 3 days the skin of the tomato started shrinking. So if you wash this tomato with the plasma activated water, the shelf life of this is increased. And if you see the report available, so some of the fruits which are very sensitive, like strawberry, strawberry actually within 1 or 2 days decays very fast. So if this kind of so plasma activated water is very useful for this kind of waters, for this kind of fruits and vegetable which has a very less shelf life. So normally what people do, they are that put their vegetable in a cold chain, or they are performing the gamma ray radiation to increase the shelf life of the material. But normally it is very expensive for the poor farmers. So if this technology is proven to be successful, it can be actually the plasma activated water can be generated in a large amount and can be supplied to farmers to use it on a regular basis. This is another example of how the plasma activated water is actually helpful for a germination of the seed. So what you see on the right height is the SEM image of how the bacteria is ruptured when you are actually treating it with the plasma activated water. So first image is the actual bacteria images. The typical scale bar is 1 micron. And what you see on the right side, that the bacteria is actually ruptured and the surface becomes rough. So it's not able to survive after it coming in contact with the plasma activated water. And the result is shown below, that when the normal water was used, and in the third case, when the plasma activated water used, the branches are much bigger as on the same time after the plasma treatment. So it really helps to grow the plants faster, or the seed to grow faster as compared to the untreated samples. So with this, I will now show some technology which our institute had developed for the textile applications. So what you see in this picture is the system which was developed for treating the angora fiber. Angora fiber is a very, it's a cottage industry in Himalayan region. So you might have heard that people are making angora fiber based sweaters, which are very smooth and very warm in wearing. So people are actually having a lot of rabbits, and then they are removing their fibers and then making sweater out of it. But the problem is, it is so smooth that once you make a sweater out of it, the fibers are coming out because they were very smooth. Or in certain cases, they have to mix it with some other wool so that it remain intact. So what we have observed, that if you treat this wool with plasma, some kind of nano roughness generated. So on the right side, you see the surface is very smooth before the treatment, and after treatment, you see some structure formation. So this structure formation actually helps to weave the sweater, and so in appearance or in color, everything remains the same, warmness remains the same, but it helps to actually the weaving of the sweater out of it. So this technology has been successfully developed for a large area, and again, because this it's a DBD plasma based technology. So what you see that it can be the system can be coupled to any other device which is actually supplying this straight angora fiber, and we have optimized the parameter how many seconds or how many time we have to treat the angora fiber. So and the technology is transferred to Inspiron Ahmedabad and Arshad Electronics Mumbai. So now so this system is actually running in the industries for treating their cottons. Another example what you see here is, you might have seen either on some WhatsApp movies or on some Facebook movies, that nowadays in salon the barber is actually burning your hair. So when he are burning your hair, and after that he's putting the dye. So what actually they are doing, they are activating, in presence of plasma only, they are activating your hairs. And what you see the example, so first one, the top image left corner is a smooth merino wool fiber, and on the right you see some kind of roughness generated. So the moment surface is rough and reactive, the dye absorption will increase. So that's how the barber, they're actually making your dye is much more effective on your hair, and the life of the dye is also increased if you actually treat it with plasma, if you make your surface little rough. Another very good example is the treatment of cotton. So normally the cotton has a natural wax on the surface, that's how it's not able to absorb any dye, and normally you do not see very good khadi clothes which are very colorful or very decorative. So because of this natural wax available on the surface, so if you treat it with plasma, you can see again the surface roughness is changing, and it's able to now absorb the dyes. So this was also very successful work. So now we have tried different kind of fabric we are treating on fiber. So this research is also going on in our institute. Another possible good example is the fading of the denim. So already the monkey wash jeans are popular in the market. So normally they use again a chemical process to make one place darker as compared to the another place on the clothes for making some designs. So there is a possibility that you use plasma torches and computer program plasma torches so that they can write anything what you want to write. So they fade the color over the textile surface. And so the way you want to write it, they can go to any place, and then simply the design you want it, they can simply fade the color from that place. And that's how you can make monkey wash jeans or any other design on the surfaces. So already worldwide, there plasma textile is also many companies. They are using the plasma-based technologies for various application of in the textile industries. So with this, I would like to now move to my own field, which is plasma nanotechnology. So plasma nanotechnology, I will be showing you some example how the surface wettability can be changed using the plasma treatment. So what you see in this picture, naturally the leaves and the lotus leaf and different kind of leaves, even in the rainy season, you can see that the water droplet is like a rolling like a ball. So the moment you shake the leaf, the water moves around. So it's not wetting on the surface. If you see high resolution images of this kind of leaves, you will see there are nanostructure as well as the micron structure available on the surface, which are responsible for the making them super hydrophobic surfaces. So nature has already given many such examples. The another example given on the bottom is the sea cicada wings. So all the insects, butterflies, and they have this kind of nanostructure over their surface so that the water do not stick to their wings, and they can even sit on the water and they can fly, and they can fly in the rain also. So we can use, with the help of plasma based process, we can actually make this kind of nanostructure on the surface, and that make them super hydrophobic. The example what you see on the right hand side is the Teflon plasma treated Teflon surface. So Teflon is a very well known polymer which is used for many applications in our either in the medical science, many components are made of Teflon, or in the R&D also different people use different content. So there's a requirement that the Teflon should be, so Teflon by nature is already hydrophobic in nature, but if you treat it with plasma under optimized condition, you can make it super hydrophobic. So the example here shown is we have treated it for in the different range of ion energy and found that you can actually change the contact angle of the polymer surface by using different plasma parameters. So what happened when you treat it, you can make different kind of freely standing nanostructure which are oriented in the direction of plasma ions. So in this picture, in this movie, what you see, we have treated 800 electron volt for 180 seconds, and you can see that when the droplet is falling on a surface, it's simply rolling. So it's not sticking to the surface, it's simply rolling. Another example is if it is actually jumping over the surface. So this kind of many other polymer can be either make super hydrophobic or super hydrophilic with the help of plasma treatment. One of the application of this kind of surface is the self-cleaning process. So what you see here on the left side in this movie, so we have put some powder intentionally on the surface which is plasma treated or untreated. So in one case, the droplet is getting bigger and bigger, so it's not cleaning the surface. And in another case, you see that it is cleaning. So like, for example, if we make a transparent super hydrophobic film, and that can be used as a top layer of a solar panel. So normally the problem with solar panel is that the dust is getting accumulated, especially in the area where you have a lot of dust. So there is a requirement. So even though people are using water to clean it, but it's not going very freely. So if the surface is super hydrophobic, then the cleaning will be faster, and then you will require less amount of water to clean it. Another good example is the water harvesting. So you might have seen in your AC, some water is actually falling down. So whatever water is actually condensed on the copper tube, it accumulated slowly, 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 and then it started falling. So if you make this kind of process happen in many industries where you are actually having a cooling line, so water accumulation and water preservation is one of the field where many industries are working, even though in the places where there is no water supply, people are developing water condensation units so that the people can get water out of it. So a lot of research is going on to develop this kind of super hydrophobic surfaces, which are efficient as compared to normal surfaces for the water accumulation. So typically water droplet, small water droplet grow in the bigger droplet, but still until the gravity doesn't allow it remain there. But if the surface is already super hydrophobic, the water droplet will roll very fast and then they will bicker very fast. And that's how the efficiency of the water condensation will increase. Another example of water treatment is till now I was showing you the super hydrophobic. In this example, you will see that the water filters which are used in our RO plant, we can actually make them hydrophilic by plasma treatment. So untreated plasma treatment, you will see that the water droplet is it's now falling on the surface. So it remained there. So if the droplet remain on the surface, it will essentially increase the time of the droplet to be passed through the filter. But if you treat it with plasma, the surface become hydrophilic. The once the surface is hydrophilic, the droplet will spread faster on the surface. And then this process will actually increase the time you want to filter your water. So you see, so water is going very fast. So the filtration time will be improved. So not only we can make hydrophobic surfaces, super hydrophobic surfaces, but also hydrophilic surfaces with the help of plasma parameter process. In this example, again, a Teflon coated film is developed on steel. So you can see how nicely it is moving over the surface. So many applications where you have a requirement of where there's a chance that the steel can corrode and after coming in the contact of water. So people are trying to have Teflon like coating, like in our automobiles, we put Teflon coating on the bottom to make it protected from the rusted water. So similarly, the Teflon like super hydrophobic coating can be developed for making water rolling over the surface and make again increasing the lifetime of that component. Another example of making nanostructures on the surface is that has been observed that when the ions are interacting on the surface, they make some kind of nanostructures. So normally in any experiment, we do not bother what is happening on the surface. We simply happy that, okay, my addition is improved, my surface becomes super hydrophobic. So if you see in the high resolution images, what you see here in the on the left side, these are atomic force microscopy images and the scale bar is 200 nanometer. So you see some kind of nanostructure formation happening when the ions are interacting on the surface. And the bottom one is the transmission electron images. So this kind of nanostructure, which are self-organized based on the parameter you have used for your plasma, they can be tailored with the help of your plasma parameter, either by changing the energy or either changing the flux of the plasma. You can make this kind of patterns, and this kind of pattern can be very, very useful for making nicely ordered chains of nanoparticles. So you might have seen that nanoparticles are giving many applications nowadays. So they are used for different applications, either for the health sector or for the self-cleaning processes or for the magnetic memories. So there's a requirement to have a very strong control on the growth of nanoparticles. Okay, so once you have this kind of pre-patterned substrate, you can we use them for making nice chains of nanoparticles, what you see on these bottom images. So ideally, if you grow nanoparticle on any surface, either they get agglomerated, one nanoparticle mixed with another nanoparticle. So their properties actually degrade. The objective is you have a very well separated nanoparticles, and you should have a control even at a nanoscale. So that's the reason. That's the reason nanoparticles arrangement is very important for certain application I'm going to show you. So one of the application is the surface enhanced Raman spectroscopy. So in this surface enhanced Raman spectroscopy, the metal nanoparticles, they are used for detecting the molecules. So Raman spectroscopy is already known process for chemical people. If you want to detect a molecule, you can use the Raman spectroscopy spectra, and then you can easily know that this is the molecule. So remember, Raman spectroscopy is one of the method which detecting the molecules. Like AFM, SEM, XRD, they cannot tell you which kind of molecule is there on the surface, but Raman spectroscopy will give you the characteristic spectra, which tells you that this is the molecule available in your solution, in your surface. So if you have a nanoparticle sitting very close to your the molecule you are detecting, you can see that the intensity of the Raman signal increases drastically. So on the left side, there is no nanoparticle, and the example I'm showing you is the rhodamine 6G molecule. It's a dye which is used in for different applications. So in the rhodamine 6G, you see that there is no peak observed in the Raman spectra. Okay, but if you use the same molecule in connection with the metal nanoparticle, you can see that the intensity increases drastically. So these are the characteristic peaks of rhodamine 6G molecule. So nanoparticle sitting in an ordered manner give better sensitivity compared to the randomly distributed nanoparticle. So that's how this template-based approach is very good for detecting the molecules. So we have developed this process over a period of time. And very important is what nowadays, there's a lot of adulterant are used in the food products. So if you see Google, you will be actually surprised. You will find that all kind of adulterants are used, whatever the daily item we are taking in our body. The example, what you see here, like sometimes you feel that the tomato is not, when you cut it, it's not as good as it should look like. Similarly, when you get the watermelon from the market, you see it's always very red. So natural watermelon is not very red, it's slightly pinkish. But when you get it from the market, the size is very small, it's very sweet, it's very red. So it is very attractive actually, but in reality, it's not the case. So people are, vendors are, because they know in which season, which fruit is coming out, which vegetable is coming out. So accordingly, they plant different kind of cheaper dyes which are available in the market without knowing that they can be carcinogenic, they can be very hazardous to human liver and different part of the body. And we consume them and get affected by these kind of problems. So what we have done actually, we are based on this surface Raman and spectroscopy based the process what we have developed, we are able to successfully detect different kind of dyes which are regularly used in industries, and they are not recommended by Food Authority of India. So we have slowly we are making a database of different this kind of products. So first example what you see is the turmeric. So methyl yellow dye is actually used in the turmeric powder. And the second example is the chili powder, and the third example is the watermelon. I'm just showing you some of the example we have done at our place. So we are able to successfully detect very, very low concentration of these dyes, which are using our template developed by the plasma processes. Another example is the melamine. So melamine is also not recommended to be used in the milk, because there are a lot of reports that even the baby died in certain cases when the melamine was used in the milk. So milk industries, in any festival season, you see a lot of artificial milk is also coming in the market. So we need to make a database of the real milk, different kind of milks, and how the cow milk giving the spectra, how the buffalo milk is giving the spectra, different kind of milks, and the database has to be generated. And from one place to another place, how the milk properties are changing, that also database has to be made. So we are taking this kind of initiative for making this kind of database with the help of surface enhanced Raman spectroscopy. And yes, we are also using this kind of template for the earlier detection of diseases. So again, in collaboration with Tata Memorial Cancer Research Institute, we are detecting the different kind of cancerous cell, so like breast cancer cells. So normally it's very difficult to see the cancerous cell. You need many such cells, but if you have a nanoparticle close to your cells, you are able to see characteristic spectra. So these are basically the cells lines and the DNA peaks which are visible. So if you have a healthy person and you have a cancerous man, you can see the how the cancerous spectra is actually different from one person to the another person. So the people are now making database of different kind of diseases. Even for corona also, people are successfully detected spectra of coronavirus using this method. Another very good example is we have developed a commercialized nanoparticle formation system. So normally, most of the institute, they are actually getting the nanoparticle for their application from foreign companies. So we have developed a process where we can actually make a large quantity nanoparticles. And the example you see here is the self-cleaning of using with the help of TiO2. So what happened in the case of TiO2, when you expose the surface to the light, it actually emits the it makes the surface active and it emits the radiation. So for example, if you are in a party and some tea fall or some turmeric powder fall on your surface or some coffee fall on your surface, you simply put a small amount of this powder on the surface and then come inside in contact with light. So you will see that slowly that stain goes away. So that's how TiO2 nanopowder, they are actually also finding application. They are antibacterial also. So we are able to make them, and this technology is also transferred to one company for commercially making nanopowders with the help of thermal plasma processes. With this, I will now come to the end of my last topic of my talk, is the plasma for space application. So our institute has done a lot of project in collaboration with ISRO. So what you see here, that this is a typical picture of a satellite. So normally the source of energy of a satellite is the solar panels. So solar panels are actually give energy, but what is the problem, that nowadays every time the capacity of the panel for producing electricity because is growing, and because more and more sensors are every time added to the satellites, and sometimes very futuristic projects are done. So there's a lot of load on the solar panels. I will tell you why it is relevant. So, and the body is fully automated. I mean, there are a lot of robotic arms used in satellites, so that they remain in a rocket, and then slowly once it is launched, it opens its expanded arms. So there are a lot of robotic arms, there are a lot of bearings used inside the satellites, and it uses communication antenna for giving signal to the places it is moving. So there's a requirement of reducing the weight of this antenna, so they cannot be made of metal, otherwise the weight will increase. And plasma thruster, which are normally a kind of ion gun only, which is used for taking the for changing the orientation. So we have worked for different projects in collaboration with ISRO and successfully helped for in different aspects. I'm touching one by one. So we have developed a concept of flexible antenna, like our dish antenna at our home is made of SS, like Tata Sky or Airtel, whatever you have. So in the similar kind of antenna is actually used in satellites. So they wanted to reduce the weight of that antenna by making a metallic surface on a polymer. So they wanted to make a polymer based antenna by putting copper coating on the surface. So normally making a metallic coating is very easy on a surface. So you just simply use any sputter based plasma process. So copper coating will come. But the moment you upscale the process, the area increases, the strain inside the film started increasing, and then the film started piling off. So we did a lot of trial and error experiment in the beginning and successfully developed a system where actually we could code so what you see in this picture is actually a small size antenna made of Lexon polymer was used. And this green color is a typical characteristic plasma of copper atoms. So whenever you are making copper coating, you will see this kind of color. So we have successfully coated this Lexon camera, and then ISRO tested it, whatever parameter they wanted to see, the reflectivity of the K alpha band and Ku band. They found it that it's more or less the same as in the case of bulk surfaces. So after successfully developing this antenna, we have given it to the ISRO, and maybe you can see in this picture the actual process is going on. So you see that the plasma ion is sputtering the copper rod which has kept inside the system at the center, and then the sputtered material of copper is actually getting coated on the electron surface. And then the plasma thruster, which I told that is this is the cause. Plasma thruster is actually giving the ions, xenon ions, which are coming out from the plasma thrusters, so that it can give equal and opposite force to the satellites. Because satellite is in space is freely floating, so even a small millinewton thrust can actually change its orientation, can change its direction. So in the case of Mars mission, they were simply firing the plasma thruster and increasing the orbital length. And in certain cases, when the mission was not successful, the thrusters were actually responsible because they did not fire at time. So that's why this plasma thruster is very crucial for any satellite mission. So ISRO is indigenously developing this kind of plasma thruster, different technologies they are using. But one of the very successful technologies is the Hall effect thruster, which is used worldwide. So in this case also, the xenon ions coming out from the surface. And what happened when this xenon ions coming out from the surface, they started eroding the material after several hours. So before any component which is mounted on the satellite, it has to be tested for several hours testing. So if it is failed, they will not mount, they will not take any risk to mount it on the satellites. So in this case, when the ions coming out after long operation, what has been observed that at just at the exit point, the ceramic material started coming out. So and it is possible that if the material is coming out, it can lead to faster erosion. It can also actually make surface slash over. Some arcing can also happen, and some the metal, whatever metal is actually eroded, it can also coat it over the surface of the solar panel. So if the solar panel is getting coated, the energy efficiency of the solar panel will also degrade. So there are a lot of issues if the metal is eroded. So the objective is that the material should not erode at all. So already they are using a material which is having very, very extremely low erosion rate, but still with time, some material is coming out. And another problem was they are indigenously developing also this material. So initially it is procured from some abroad companies. So they are also optimizing different kind of materials so that the erosion rate can be reduced. So for them, actually we did a lot of studies and we developed a system where we can measure the erosion rate inside the material. We also measure the property of those material, how the surface is changing, how the dielectric behavior is changing, how the material is behaving under different conditions. And we have successfully given the very useful data, and with the help of IPR, they are able to successfully develop this boron nitride silicate material, which recently it has been tell that the material will now use in the plasma thruster, and the thruster which is indigenously developed using this material will actually now scheduled to be mounted in the satellite. So it's a very successful project which has been done in many steps. We have also done the plasma characterization of the plasma thrusters which are used on ISRO. So the power supply which are developed in IPR, they are regularly using in their plasma thruster units. So what you see in the first image is a robotic arm. Again, it can move in 360, 180 degree direction from one place to another. So that in situ completely inside the vacuum, you can see the plasma parameter or the plume of the divergence of the plasma thruster. Another very important experiment which we have done or still we are doing this project in several steps is that when the satellite is actually moving in different orbits, so there are different orbits like lower Earth orbit or the geosynchronous orbit, a very, very low density plasma is there, either there or the electron energy is there, energetic electrons are there. So our satellite panel, the top layer is actually a dielectric surface. So and there is no ground available on the satellite in space. So what happened, like the arcing phenomena I told you in the beginning. So in this case also the arcing phenomena, the solar panel started charging, and this charge can be as high as in that it can generate a potential difference between the top layer and the bottom layer. And then that can lead to some kind of arcing in the solar panel. So if the solar panel started arcing, it can actually lead to very severe arcing also, which can damage it permanently. So that solar system cannot be used. So already this kind of phenomena was first observed by NASA. So they predict the life of the satellite for a certain period. And what they found that even much, much before the panel stopped working, and that's how they have to abort their mission. So many such event has been observed worldwide that the space plasma actually interfere in the functionality of the solar panel. So ISRO also realized the same problem, and then we have developed a facility where we can actually simulate the space-like plasma, and in real, and we have performed the experiment, and I can show you the movie. So there are several arcing happening over the surface, small arcing. They are not dangerous, but at one point of time, the arcing is so dangerous that it can start ablating the material from the surface. So in this case, the solar panel cannot be used. So we have given several useful suggestions for developing how to modify the design, how to modify it, what other arrangement can be done so that the number of arc on the surface can be reduced, and how the tenure, the duration of the arc can be reduced. So different kind of experiment we have performed. And even today, this is a test facility available at IPR where we are regularly doing experiment. So worldwide, people are making a database. Again, a standardization of the process for testing solar panel before it mounted to the satellite. So it has to be tested and qualified before it mounted to the panel, to the satellites. This is a picture, which is a typical frame of that arcing event. So you can see a broad spread developed. So with this, I will like to conclude my talk. I think I've shown many of the successful technologies which are developed by our colleagues in different directions. But what is the need is that because as you see, plasma is an interdisciplinary branch where the physicists, engineers, biologists, agriculture people, many other people actually, the expertise is needed. We cannot simply, we can develop the system, but the testing has to be done by the users. So we need many people should come forward with ideas, and we are always welcoming this kind of approach to work together. So with this, I would like to conclude my talk. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mukesh, for the nice talk. So if there are some questions, you can ask him. Or you can even type the question in the chat box.
Yeah. And I have written my email ID. Those who are watching on YouTube, I will see if there are any questions, I will answer them through my email.
I see something in the chat box, somebody called Mr. Uday Kumar. He writes that it's a very interesting talk. It covers prospect of technical and non-technical person. We need much more such talks. So are there any more questions? It seems that the talk
was, I thought everything is clear or nothing is clear.
No, I think it is very clear. People have understood. It's kept at the right level for common people or people with some understanding about plasmas. So Mukesh, thank you very much. And I have Dr. Shantanu Karkari. He has a question, so you must speak there.
Mukesh.
Yes, Shantanu.
I enjoyed your talk very much.
Thank you.
This technology, this pyrolysis system, and this especially the skin one and the treatment of the skins and other things. So about the pyrolysis system, how it is working in India?
So currently, so as I showed you the example, so in certain places it is running, and certain places there are some different kind of administrative problems. So the system is fine for some administrative reason. There are other communities which do not want to support it because it is actually hurting their earnings. So they create different kind of problems. But actually the system, we are getting different, very good feedback. And as you see this, the engineering who actually got this technology, they're getting orders.
So the question is that what is the challenge? Why they are apprehensive about... What is the challenge?
So your voice is not clear. Sir, can you repeat it?
Hello. क्या शांतनु क्या बोल क्या पूछ रहे हो?
मैं ये पूछ रहा हूँ कि मतलब what is the challenge behind why the people, I mean, it's less as you say, trying to explain that like in the hospitals it's not some administrative reasons or what?
नहीं देखो क्या you are talking about the pyrolysis.
हाँ sir, what is happening?
जो technology vendor है अभी हमारा जो BL engineer ने अभी कुछ चार सिस्टम ऑलरेडी मार्केट में डाल दिए हैं, एक IIT दिल्ली में है और एक कुछ बैंक नोट प्रेस में है, और तीन सिस्टम का ऑर्डर ऑलरेडी उसके पास में है. अभी क्या है कि देर इज ए कॉम्पिटिशन बिटवीन या इंसिनरेशन एंड प्लाज्मा बेस्ड थिंग्स, एंड इंसिनरेशन में थोड़ा कॉस्ट थोड़ा कम है मगर वो पोल्यूटिंग टेक्नोलॉजी है, पर फिर भी लोग बाग जो है इंसिनरेटेड लॉबी इज वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग. तो वो दे आर एबल टू मैनेज राइट नाउ. एंड दूसरा चीज जो है कि ये जो है थोड़ा बिकॉज ऑफ पावर सप्लाई एंड अदर थिंग्स थोड़ा कॉस्ट तो आ जाता है, एंड देन द ग्रेफाइट इलेक्ट्रोड्स आर यूज, तो थोड़ा सा पर केजी में आप डिस्पोजल करेंगे, यू विल बी डेफिनेटली नॉट पोल्यूटिंग द एनवायरनमेंट.
आई गॉट इट, आई गॉट इट, बिकॉज ऑफ द ओके ओके. सेकंड थिंग वाज दैट द स्किन ट्रीटमेंट दैट यू आर शोइंग एंड स्पेशली द कैंसर ट्रीटमेंट. Okay, so how it is in the worldwide, like not only in India, but it must have like we use in other parts of the world. How they are, what is the present status there?
So I think in certain cases, many places, the recent, even the literature, what I see, people are still trying the animal models, people are trying, because getting the approval for on human trial is difficult. So I don't know whether it's already there in the for the cancer treatment, whether it's already there.
But hello sir, can I answer the question?
Yeah, please.
Sir, as far as the world scenario is concerned, sir, it is being right now, it is being used in various universities, especially in Germany and US, for the clinical trials in human. Sir, recent publication is from the Dr. Metalman. He has used this type of jet for the treatment of head and neck cancer for 6 patients after taking the clinical trial permissions, and he is studying the what actually is happening there. So if we see the literature and we see the scenario of the world right now, what we observe is, except in Germany and US, still people are working on labs or animal models only, but in US by somehow they are in the clinical trial of human also.
Okay, thank you.
Hello.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, please.
Okay. First of all, thanks for nice this lecture, this type of lecture. My question is related to the use of plasma for the agricultural activity. So in this talk, we came to know the use of plasma for the seed. So it is applicable for all type of seed or a particular category of seed?
So as of now, we have only tried selected seeds. So making a generalized statement may not be true, but as I said, that it's a very time-consuming process. So we have tried certain seeds with the help of agriculture universities, and we are based on that we can say that it's working. But we need to do many experiments to finally tell that.
Okay, can I add something?
Yeah, please.
Actually, sir, these seeds where have some seeds have a problem in germination, where they have a hard seed coat, or sometimes they remain dormant for some time, and because they are not able to absorb water easily. So for such type of seeds where have a problem of hard seed coat or problem in germination, like the okra seed, which is like that for universities, then they are like they have the capsicum seed, they have a hard seed coat, so they will not absorb water easily. So such type of seeds we are trying, but obviously we have to search for more seeds that which have a problem, not all type. Some type of seeds are already germinating rate is very good. If you put 100 seeds out of that, 90-95 already germinate, so they have, don't have any problem. But such seeds there is a problem. So for such type of seeds we are trying to do the plasma treatment.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Hello. Hello. Mukesh.
Yeah, please.
Yes, actually, I also wanted to know that this pesticides, I mean, shown one sentence like that, this can be used for cleaning. For cleaning of the, I mean, vegetables and food, for the removal of the pesticide. So, I mean, is it currently, it is, or it is removing some, you know, whether are the required content or the disease?
Bhumi, I'm not getting your voice. I think you want to ask that the pesticide removal. We have proven a concept that yes, that kind of plasma exposure can actually remove the pesticide over the surface, but again on a selected batch only. So at the moment, it has been tested successfully, but no product has been developed based on this. And I think we have tested that whatever the permissible limit, that it can still sustain.
Yeah, Mukesh.
Yeah.
हेलो मुकेश.
यस सर
हाँ, उसमें प्लाज्मा एक्टिवेटेड वाटर और इसमें जिसमें ओजोन और ये सब होता है, ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट्स रहते हैं, देखिए दिस दैट कैन आल्सो बी यूज्ड फॉर रिमूविंग द पेस्टिसाइड्स. यू कैन सी इवन द कैंट इज मेकिंग सम ओजोनाइजर्स काइंड ऑफ थिंग व्हिच इज क्लीनिंग द पेस्टिसाइड्स. सो सिमिलरली प्लाज्मा एक्टिवेटेड वाटर वेयर ओजोन, हाइड्रोजन परऑक्साइड एंड various nitrates are there present, it can also help in removing the pesticides. If when somebody is using plasma activated water to clean the things.
Okay, if there are no more questions, then we should thank the speaker, Dr. Mukesh Ranjan, for covering a large area of plasma application, right from very simple applications, simple what we think as, you know, seed germination and things like that, to very exotic applications like paste and other. There is a question by Mr. Praveen. Please see my question, he's writing. So, Mr. Praveen, can you put your question? He has written, nice talk, sir. Plasma pencil application can be used for face, body, acne treatment. The small spots which are there. So, Mukesh, would you like to answer that or somebody else?
I think sound is, I don't know if it's a problem of my network or what. I'm not able to listen to the sound very clearly.
You can actually look at the chat box.
Let me see.
Mr. Praveen is asking whether there is a plasma application for face or body acne treatment and spots which happen on the face, probably that one.
For face, body and treatment. I saw this kind of work has been done. That people are using to remove the stain, some black stain on the body. Those kind of work has been done worldwide. So we have not tried it here, but certainly this can be a possibility which can be tried. So as I said in the end, that we need a proper collaborator. There are many such applications is possible, especially for the skin-related diseases. But we need to find a proper collaborator to do this kind of testing in a very phased manner. So the answer is yes, but we have not tried.
Okay, Mukesh, then so thank you on behalf of all the participants as well as all those who are on YouTube, not directly in this link. So we thank you once again for your time and the nice talk. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You may quit now.